suicide. It's a topic that we've become all too familiar with, and it can be devastating, of course. But how does it affect our military? Well, that's exactly what we're talking about today with our coastal expert from Horizon Behavioral Health. Joining me now is Jeffrey Frey, who is a psychiatric physician assistant. Hi, Jeffrey, it's great to see you.
Hi, glad to be back again. Talk about this important subject.
So let's start off by talking about our veterans. Are veterans at a higher risk where suicide is concerned, say, more than non-veterans?
You would think that based on media reports and the publicity that veteran suicides receive, but the statistics actually show that veterans commit suicide at a comparable rate to non-veterans or civilians. Currently, suicide is the 10th leading cause of death in the United States among all populations. There are 21 million veterans, 19 million of them are male, about 2 million are female. In the general population, there are 93 suicides per day, and in the veteran population, there are approximately 20 veterans. Now, of that 20 million I mentioned, veterans that are in the United States, only 10 million of them are actually actively seeking or getting treatment, either through the VA or through other providers to treat their depression or any other mental health problems they may have. So half of the veterans who have potential risk factors for suicide aren't currently being treated or seen.
Well, what has been the trend in the number of veteran suicides?
Well, actually, it's been going up in age groups from 19 to 29. And it's actually decreasing in the older veterans, 55 to 60 and above. However, the actual number of suicides by veterans are in the older age group because there are a lot more of them. You know, we are talking the Vietnam veteran age group, whereas there are a lot more of those folks than the current 18 to 29 year olds who have been involved in the Afghan and Iraqi wars. So the trend is increasing in that younger group, but the current number is actually higher than in the older veterans.
So let's take a look at male versus female veterans who are at risk of suicide. I mean, is it one more than the other?
Veterans tend to have higher rates of attempts, probably two-thirds higher than females. And unfortunately, when males tend to act out on suicide, they tend to use guns or weapons, whereas females tend to overdose or use other less lethal means. So the completed suicide rate is higher with males than it is with females.
So of course, this is all so important right now. And in Savannah, the Coastal Empire and Lowcountry, of course, we know that we have a high number of military and veterans who live right here around us. Why would you say this is so important during this time?
Well, this is the time, you know, the holidays are coming up here. It's getting near the fall. We have a lot of veterans that have been deployed out of Fort Stewart. The active duty folks, they come out, and then they, when their time is up in the active duty side, they transition into civilian life. Yeah, so the transitioning from active duty into civilian life is somewhat stressful for individuals because they're losing their full-time job. They may not have a civilian job lined up. They're losing a lot of support and camaraderie they build while on active duty and in the active military. And those are stressors that some people just can't handle.
So what are some signs or risk factors where suicide is concerned?
One of the primary risk factors, and everyone should take this one seriously, is a prior suicide attempt that didn't go through to completion. We found that statistics show that almost 80% of those who attempt it once will attempt it again. So that's a major risk factor. The second important risk factor is if they have a mental health condition such as major depression, anxiety disorder, bipolar disorder. Those individuals are at higher risk than someone who does not have a additional mental health issue. And one of the third major factors is a recent life event that is causing stress. You know, like I mentioned before, switching from active duty to a civilian, you may not have a job, your income may drop, you may have marital issues, you may be going through a divorce, a separation, or there could be a death in the family. Any of those can increase the risk for someone who isn't able to cope to off themselves.
So life-changing events is definitely something very important.
Right.
So what about help, Jeffrey? How can folks get help?
But as far as seeking out help, there are Veterans Crisis Line, which is a line established and run by the Veterans Administration.
Yes, and of course our viewers can take a look at the numbers that we are showing right now as hotline numbers that you can call.
Right.
If you suspect or if you need support or if you want more information or you need help, take a look at those numbers and jot those down.
And you can call, you can text, you can go to their website. They even have a line for the hard of hearing. Additionally, you can go to our Horizon Behavioral Health website and click on the resources, and it lists those numbers and the National Suicide Prevention Hotline.
Thank you so much, Jeffrey, for being here today and providing us with the wonderful information that you did involving suicide.
It was my pleasure, and I hope this helps someone out there in the audience. Don't be afraid to call. That's what we're here for.
Thanks so much. If you'd like more information on Horizon Behavioral Health or any of our Coastal Experts, just go to our Coastal Experts page. You'll find that at WSAV.com.